Hi, hello. Welcome to GERTC Videos, your daily supply of solutions to engineering problems. If you like what you see, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time may bago kaming mga videos. Okay, so in this video, we will discuss pickup points of piles for least shear and moment. Very common, this is a very common problem sa board exam. So, halos sa sunod-sunod ng mga board exam, palaging lumalabas itong ganito. Although may formula ito, no? At the same time, i-deride mo lang din natin yung formula. Ah? So, okay. So, what do we have here? So, we have a 450 by 450 by 18 meter long precast concrete pile to be lifted from the casting bed. Unit weight of concrete is 24 kilonewtons per cubic meter. Okay, the pile is lifted horizontally at 1.8 meters from each end. Okay, find the maximum moment due to its weight. So, yung unang condition, binigay yung location ng pickup point, hahanapin natin yung maximum moment due to its own weight lang. Pangalawa, at what equal distance from the ends of the pile should it be lifted so that the resulting shear is the least possible value? Sabi nga, the maximum moment is smallest. The maximum shear is least. Okay? Ang pangatlo naman, the pile is lifted horizontally, the same pa rin. Kaya lang, yung moment naman, saan natin i-pick up so that the maximum moment is the least possible value? Okay, maraming nalilito. Bakit maximum moment siya tapos least? Tingnan natin, explain natin mamaya bakit ganun yung principle niya. Alright, so ito yun. So meron tayong pile from the casting bed. If we cap natin, siguro iloload na natin doon sa truck. Alright, so gagamit tayo of course ng crane. Ayan, halimbawa ito na yung cable na magpipick up doon sa ating pile, yung dalawa. So we will pick it up at a distance from the ends. Equal distance, sabihin na natin X by X and X, and then ililift siya, dahan-dahan. Ayan. Okay. So, this is now the diagram, no? The load diagram. So we can make it like this. Supported at this, no? Simple support. So 1.8 yung ating given yung part 1, 1.8. And then, this is 14.4. So the load, kumpitin muna natin yung uniform load. Alright, so due to own weight lang. So how do you compute that? So the intensity of the load. So di ba, paano pa compute? That will be unit weight of the material here of concrete times the cross-sectional area. 24 times 0.45 times 0.45. Huwag mo na i-multiply ng length. Pag inumpit mo ng length, pwede. Pero yung makukuha mo, total weight. Ang gusto natin yung kilonewton per linear meter. So only cross-sectional area. So that's 4.86 kilonewtons per cubic meter. So, nakuha na natin yung uniform load. Lagay natin doon, 4.86. Okay, next, kunin natin yung mga reaction. Well, obviously, the two are symmetrically located. So, obviously, the two are the same. The total reaction is half of the total load. So, 4.86 times 18 divided by 2. So, each of them is 43.74. Okay? Sige. Ito, mas madali ito. Madali lang gawan to ng moment shear and moment diagram. So, I would require or I would suggest, i-draw nyo na lang. Pero kung isipin nyo naman, no, for those na medyo advanced na dito, dalawa lang naman yung possible position dito ng maximum moment. Either dito sa support or at the midspan. Yun na yun. Worry mo lang. I cannot say na nasa beachman palagi kasi depende yun sa location ng ating support. Baka yung support mo mas masyadong malayo from the end. Lalabas na yung moment at support is lesser. So, for the sake of explanation, mas magandang i-draw natin yung diagram. I-draw natin yung shear diagram. Anyway, mabilis lang naman to. Alright, so the starting shear at this end is 0. So, you will start at this point. And then, bababa tayo ng 4.86 times 1.8. So, ito na yung next point. 4.86 times 1.8 is negative 8.748. Okay? And then, akyat tayo ng 43.74. So, magiging 34.992. And then, bababa tayo ng 4.86 times 14.4. So, bababa ulit yan. Okay? Well, by symmetry, expected natin, this should be 34.992, negative. And then, nakakyat ng 43.74 to here, and then, bababa ng 4.86 times 1.8, so that will be your shear diagram. Okay? So, yun. Well, of course, because of symmetry, obvious na to na nasa gitna ng 14.4. Na? So, kumpitin natin yung areas ng shear diagrams. So, this is 1/2, 1.8 times 8.748. So, negative 7.873. And then, ito naman ay 1/2, 34.992 times kalahati ng 14.4. That's 7.2. Yes? So, this is positive 125.972. Ito naman ay pareho din, kaya negative lang. Ayan. And then, this is the same area ito dito. Positive lang. Okay? Oh, sanay ka dito, mabilis lang naman itong gawin. Ha? Okay, and then the moment diagram, the moment at this end is 0. So, you'll start here. Then, bababa ka ng 7.873. So, nandito ka na sa baba. Negative 7.873. Akyat ka ng 125.972. So, magiging 118.098. And then, bababa ka ng 125, pariho niyan. And then, akyat ng 7, so magiging 0. Ayun. Well, okay, pwede mo nang hindi i-draw yung diagram. No? The maximum moment is 118.098. Ala, yun na. Well, of course, if you want the diagram, then yun. Maximum, your moment diagram. So, yun yung ating maximum bending moment, 118.1. Dan dito sa gitna. It will not always be there. Ha? Kasi kung i-move natin ito, let's say gawin natin itong 3 meters, lalaki ito, ito naman liliit. Ha? Pag masyadong malaki, malayo yan. Halimbawa, di ba 18 yan, 9 meters. Gawin natin 5. I'm sure, ito na yung mas malaki kaysa dito. Ganon yung behavior niya. Ha? Lalaki ito negatively if you move this closer towards the center. Okay, so 118 yung ating sagot. Yung pangalawa, at what equal distance from the end should the pile be lifted so that the resulting shear is smallest? So, walang ano yung location niya. Na, so, paano ba yun? Okay, how will this behave? Yung ano, how will the shear and moment be affected by the support points? Okay, para maintindihan natin, again, may formula ito ha, pero I want you to listen how, ano na-derive yung formula. Alright, okay. Tingnan niyo to ha. Suppose na nilift natin yung pile at the ends. Okay? So the shear diagram will look like this. Of course, the shear here is WL over 2. WL over 2. The maximum moment is WL squared over 8. Now, kapag binug natin closer to the center yung ating support. So ganun. Ang shear diagram niya magiging ganun. Just like what happened kanina. Ito. So yung shear, mahahati yan. Hindi siya magsosolo. Meron siya negative, tapos magpapositive, and so on. Yung moment naman, ito positive moment lang, walang negative moment. Pero with the support moved closer to the center, magkakaroon na ng negative. So ito liliit ito compared to that. Ito naman, medyo, this will increase with the distance. No? And then if we move further, closer pa yung ating support, magiging ganun to. This will increase further, and this will decrease. Tinan nyo naman yung shear. Kanina, malaki ito. Ito, maliit. Ito naman, lumaki lalo. Yan, lumiit. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, nagbabago yung maximum shear and moment depende sa location ng ating support. So, paano natin makukuha, ano yung principle behind, makuha natin yung least shear, least maximum shear, or least maximum moment? Okay, sinabi ko na nga, mag-i-increase yung negative shear, mag-decrease yung positive shear. Ito naman, malaki na yung negative shear, lumiit yung negative shear. So, yung shear mo ay, yung maximum shear mo ay pinakamaliit kung yung dalawang shear, yung maximum negative shear at saka yung maximum positive shear, parehas. Yun yung point na pinakamaliit yung ating absolute value ng shear. Ganon din sa moment. Pinakamaliit ang maximum moment ko, ang maximum negative moment here equals the maximum positive moment. Na? Yung kanilang absolute value. Yun yung gagawin natin na equation. Okay? Balikan natin yung beam, ha? Sige. This time, I will derive the formula. Ha? Gagamit ako ng variable. Gagamit ako ng variable. Alright? So, here, so yung shear natin at 1 is negative W times X. Ito na. Itong shear here. The reaction is W L over 2, di ba? So, gawin ko lang siyang variable para maging general, ano, ma-derive natin yung formula. So, aakyat yan ng W L over 2. So, that will become V2 natin is negative W X plus W L over 2. Okay? So, sinabi ko kanina, for least maximum shear, yung absolute value nito equals the value of this. Absolute value means positive value. Kasi hindi maaaring maging equal yung negative sa positive, di ba? So, i-take natin yung positive value nito. Kasi ito, positive naman talaga to, no? So, okay. So, ito na maging resulta niya. Wx equals this one. Tinanggal ko na yung negative, ha? Kasi absolute value yung gagamitin natin. Yun na. Makakancel yung ating W dyan, masasolve mo yung x. Ang lalabas dyan, 2x equals L over 2 or x equals L over 4. Formula yan. Formula. For least maximum shear, ilagay mo yung pick-up point mo, 1/4 of the length from the end, L over 4. So the answer here is 18 over 4 or that is 4.5 meters. Ayos. Okay. Next. For least maximum moment, pareho din. Equate natin yung maximum positive moment na to the negative moment. Of course, absolute value nire. Okay? Sige, tinan natin. So, moment, yung moment dito is, okay, negative W times X over 2. Ito yun, no? Negative W times X over 2. Ang, okay, yung positive moment naman natin, M, is equal to, okay, so, can you do this? Okay, R times the moment arm, R is W L over 2 times the moment arm minus the uniform load, W times L over 2 times L over 2 over 2. Okay, I hope you can follow this. Ito yung reaction, no? Reaction. Tapos yung moment arm from the center is L over 2 minus X. Ito yun, no? Minus yung total, yung uniform load. W times L over 2, ito, times L over 2 over 2. Okay. Yan yan. Okay. Simplify mo ng konti, magiging ito yung resulta niya. Kinumbay ko lang yung like terms. Okay, so next. For least maximum moment, bending moment, equate natin yung absolute value ng moment 1 to the moment 2. So, positive value nito equals ito. Okay? Hindi ko na lang expand, okay, to make the story short na lang. Pag in-expand mo yan, magiging quadratic yan. Anyway, pag in-expand mo yan, and then talagang susolvin mo quadratic formula, ito yung magiging formula niya. Ito yung exact formula. Square root of 2 minus 1 over 2L. Yan yung formula niya. Or that is 0.2071L. Or the usual value ginagamit, kalimitan, 0.21L. Pero ito yung exact value talaga. Okay? Ito yung for least maximum moment. Ito naman yung for least maximum shear. So the answer, X equals 3.73 meters. Yun ang ating sagot. Okay? So, well, po sa board exam naman, ang hiningi, ganun lang. Ewan ko lang solve na ganito. Ganun din yung point mo. Na? So, ang atin lang dito yung principle. Ang principle. Meron din isang problem, we will do it later on, na yung pile pinick up at one point lang. At one point. So, yung one end rest on the ground, the other one point distance X. Hanapin yung X for least maximum shear and least maximum moment. Na? We will have it next time. Na? So we will load, sa ngayon marami na rin video natin. So maybe one or two videos a day lang muna tayo, ha? Parami na yung video natin. And salamat sa lahat ng nag-subscribe sa ating channel. This inspires us to load more videos on this channel, in this channel. Okay? And again, I invite everyone to, kung interesado kayo sa dahil sa lockdown, hindi pa safe mag-conduct ng classroom session sa review, no? Invite ko kayo sa ating online review. We will start on June 1. Okay? Online. Panoorin niyo yung video na sa channel natin ito. Okay? So, again, so please subscribe to our channel. No? And then, I hope you learned a lot from this video. And don't forget, no? To subscribe and hit the bell icon para ma-update kayo sa lahat ng ating bagong videos. Thank you so much.